Hello and welcome back to another Let's Play Dwarf Fortress. This time, 2010. Yeah. So I've found a spot which I consider to be suitable and challenging at the same time. It has a river, and it has flux stone, and some sand stuff, and mountains and grass and trees, but it's also got some very sinister surroundings, including two of the river tiles. So I think we may be experiencing some sinisterness. Oh, it wants me to go smaller. Well, fine. How about that? There's still plenty of sinisterness. Oh, hell. Go with it. Alright, well, we will prepare carefully for the journey. And the first thing we should do is customize our dwarves. So I am going to be going by the list of people who signed up on the forums for dwarf names. And I will be going down them one by one, dwarf by dwarf. So first seven are the first seven who asked for names. Paradoxine OP. Why did the music just stop? Okay, weird. Larry, I hate you. Okay, weird again. And we have Brandon Kuhn. And we have, whoops. Acleonex. And then we have Squee. And then we have Tim Ashcroft. And then finally we have Mansikir. Now they all ask for professions. Pretty much everybody asks for professions, but that ain't how I roll. So you get whatever job I assign to you. So I'm going to have a couple of minors. And by that I don't mean people under the age of 18. Who will also be dabbling in... Well, maybe I should think about this. I'll be back. Okay, we have Paradox and ELP and Larry, I Hate You are both miner slash masons. And then Brandon Kuhn and Aclanex are woodcutters slash carpenters. Squee is a building designer slash brewer. And he's also a novice cook, so he can make the kitchen. And then we have Tim Ashcroft, who is a herbalist and a farmer. And then Mansiker, who is just a cook. And I added some items to this. I tweaked around some of the stuff that we had so that we could have extra... two dogs, one male, one female, and added some extra cave lobsters for the shells, I think, and then some more stuff. Anyway, I think we're good. So let's carry on then. Prepare for the journey to Mengom. Mengom ho! We're off to see the Mengom. Eventually, maybe. Oh man. Lash crushes. Strike the motherfucking earth. Let's strike that shit. Alright, so we have a little brook ski here. And then we have, let's take a look at the... Okay, so there's a tiger. Great. Fucking tiger. Alright. Looks like we got some ponds and then chert. A couple of different Z levels here. A lot of trees, and you know, this looks like a nice, peaceful, happy place for a fort. So I think I'll dig into this mountainous area here and see if we can't find ourselves a nice place to camp out for the night. Holy crap. We just struck bauxite. Now all we have to do is hope we have freaking magma. And I don't know if we do. So we may not, but, you know... Maybe we can trade for magma. I don't know. Got bituminous coal, though, so... Even if we don't find magma, we'll have fire! and moss agates. So I'm getting an area here for beds and doors to be constructed, and I'm finding some silty areas down here for stockpile creation, hopefully. We'll see, because I don't want to gather up too much stone. But everything looks like it's going good so far. The lion took off, although a pack of bonobos has shown up here. I don't know what he's doing. Oh, he's going to do a wood cutting type thing. And yeah, looking good. Paradoxian is our expedition leader, and he is constructing a door. He is everything and nothing. And he wants nothing from me. Everybody's doing jobs and stuff, so that's good. And I think everything's going pretty well. Why, look at this! We have a couple of goats! Only they're zombie mountain goats. No muscle, no fat, no front leg fat, and no heart. Everything is rotten. Banes. Sorry. everything's going good here. We are digging out a food storage and a dining room. And over here, if all goes well... Hold on, game. Hold on. Whoa. It's okay. I forgive you. Don't worry. Settle down. Black sand doesn't sound very fertile soil-ish. So maybe I'll need to go up here and see if we can find some other places to do our farming at, but I don't know. We'll see. I'm still thinking about the farming stuff, but it's going to be something we'll have to figure out pretty quick here. If stuff can grow on sand, then we're set, and if not, then we are screwed. I don't know. Zombie marmot! And the tiger's back. And he's checking out our wagon site. Getting awfully close to it as well. Lion, tiger! Oh, he's gonna kill one of our dogs. Run away, dog! mostly just waiting for the mining to finish up now after they get a drink. And we may be able to use some of this water here to flood the stuff until we can get an aqueduct set up. Problem being that I can't find any soil deep enough. What? Uh-oh. Zombie marmot, run! Run from the zombie marmot. Where is it? It's really far away. I hope. Run! Ah, well, anyway. Moving on. Okay, whoa, problem. This zombie marmot is really close to my fortress. I think it might be time to set up a meeting area and then maybe go hide inside for a little bit. Because I have built doors here and here, and then the other entrance is right here. Yeah, the marmot's coming for us. Everybody get inside. Where the fuck is my get inside order? It's not... I can't... There's no... What? What the fuck, 2010? The go inside order is gone. Oh shit. hang on a second. Okay, so bit of a problem here. I couldn't figure out how to do the burrow thing, so I told everybody to go in here to a burrow, but then that didn't work, so I recruited them all into the military and ordered them all to move here. But one of them went over and killed this zombie hoary marmot really, really quickly. And so I was like, oh, okay, well, I'll just go kill this one over here. Well, they've all been wrestling with it for a long time, and it doesn't appear to be dying anytime soon. I tried to change my woodcutters into woodcutters, and then I told them to go and get their axes, but they refused to do that. They're just standing there. And so I don't really know what to do. I mean, I'm you know, it's like weird. So yeah, they're all wrestling the zombie hoary marmot, and I guess next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress Mode, we will find out the fate of all of us versus a very stubborn hoary marmot. Oh, and on the bright side is that everybody has become an elite wrestler. So, yeah, good stuff. Oh, he's faint. Oh, just what we need, a faint zombie. Alrighty, well, next time on Let's Play Dwarf Fortress, more zombie killing or hugging very, very ineffectively.